Hi, this video is a video about a matter concerning an abuse and a mistreatment by a nonprofit organization over a Christian. Now, I could make this video 5 hours long if I wanted to. I could read lots and lots of articles that I've written, or I could keep it short and pick one article that I wrote to kind of sum up the whole thing. But I think what's best is you just hear from my heart what's on my mind and what I remember, and let you think about it. So what happened was I quit playing racquetball in 2001, and then I came back to play racquetball again in 2008. And after about a year's playing, I got an interest in some people who wanted to hold another tournament in Alberta because there was not enough racquetball tournaments in Alberta. And we called this the Alberta Racquetball Top 16 Invitational. And not only did I have that interest, but I also had the approval or the recommendation by somebody I had to go through to run this tournament. So to run this tournament, I had to have a meeting with this person. Her name is Barbara May. She gets paid 50, 60, 70,000 a year, plus, you know, $20,000 expense account from the Alberta government to be sort of the office person for the Alberta Racquetball Association. Anyway, I was required to meet with her one day. And when I went and met with her, we discussed various things. And to be honest with you, there was not one thing that she brought up that contributed to how I wanted to run the tournament. In fact, everything was sort of an obstacle, and I didn't like any of her ideas. For example, she suggested refs wear uniforms or hold the tournament in another province, and there's just a long list of things. At any rate, that's not the major issue. The major issue is that when I was, after the meeting was all done, you know, she said she would approve the tournament to the board of the Alberta Racquetball Association, and I thought that, well, that's great. We're going to have a great tournament. But then what happened was a day later, she sends an email out to everybody. And this email, she lied in it twice. And this what sparked my response because of her lying. What she said was two things. Number one, she told me not to use the R2 sports program, to, you know, get the tournament up and running or get it initiated or get the beginning steps of it to start, which is a lie, which is a total lie. And I go through a sort of a 21 point proof through, various conversations with people and emails and whatnot, proving she totally lied and she did this to protect her hide. The evidence clearly shows that not only, you know, she was talking with me about how to use the program. She didn't know how to use it, but, and I, you know, I got approval to run the program from the president of the Canadian Racquetball, from Marshall Barnoff. And I talked to other members of the ARA about it, about how to use it. And I even had one of the members of the ARA's son register for the tournament. Okay, so what sparked my response, remember, is she lied to protect her hide, right? She felt negligent in herself in not telling me not to use the program because I had it all set up. I had a logo on it. I had basically the term all ready to go just for the fun. Now that all we needed was the final approval from the Alberta Racquetball Association. Do you understand that this is her lying to protect her hide at my expense? So she's making me look bad by her lying. Now, number two, her next lie is she says she didn't think I was either competent or organized enough to run the tournament. Now, it's not difficult to run a tournament, right? It's pretty simple. It's not a big issue. So she was crass and rude there. And now, what I think kind of sparked her hostility is after our meeting, I emailed Mark Cowett and I said to him, I didn't like any of these ideas. And I went through various ideas that she had and I didn't approve of any of them. And in fact, when Mark was at the meeting for part of the time, he didn't really like some of those ideas either. Now, I'm not bringing that point up other, for any other reason, not to put her down, but to show that, you know, she's not really connected with racquetball very well, that she would even suggest many of these wrong ideas. But it's how she responded to what I had said about her. So I was sort of saying I was annoyed with her. In fact, I used the word with Mark, annoyed. And then she comes back and says she's annoyed with me. Why she's annoyed with me, she doesn't really say why. But anyway, so that's the problem, okay? So this sparks an email thing going on. Now some other people are getting in on the conversation. And as the emails are progressing back and forth, because I have talked to several people on the Alberta Racquetball Association board, such as Jerry Slamko at the time, back in 2009, about Christianity. Mark Cowett as well. And so everybody knows that I'm a Christian. I was born again January 2001. And I've had conversations with various people in the racquetball community about faith, Christianity, how you need to come to the cross as a helpless sinner to receive the Lord Jesus as your Savior. And if you don't, you're going to go to hell. And this is not accepting any Jesus, it's accepting God of the Bible. That, you know, we're talking about the Trinity, right? God the Father, God the Son, God the Spirit. Any other kind of Christianity is not Christianity. Anyway, so they know I have this faith, and they know that I know that they're going to go to hell if they don't give their life to Christ. So what happens in the heart of man is he needs to self-exalt himself if he's rejected God. Instead of placing Christ as the center of his life, he places himself as the center. So he needs now to exalt himself above that person who's a Christian, who has his faith in Christ. And the way he'll try to do this is to try to find fault with you in your conduct or whatever. And I truly believe in my heart of hearts, this is what is going on in just a few people in the racquetball community in Edmonton, namely John Halko, Mark Cowett, Jerry Slamko. By the way, Jerry Slamko, Mark Cowett, and James Braley have since left the Alberta Racquetball Association. Because right now it's 2012. This incident occurred in 2009. And I am, as a result, banned from the Alberta Racquetball Association. It's been going on 4 years. I think I have the record for the entire history of the Alberta Racquetball Association for being banned. You know, I didn't get into a fight with anybody. There has been a couple of physical fights in the history of the Alberta Racquetball Association, but none of them have ever been either banned, or I think the most one incident occurred. A person was banned for 1 year, and that was it. I'm going on 4 years now, banned for exposing Barbara May publicly for lying to protect her hide. She's the one who banned me, right? Think about that. So there's these emails that are, you know, corresponding back and forth, and, you know, I'm realizing this is not really a matter of anything other than their hostility towards, you know, my God and my faith in Christ, because none of them are Christians. There was not a single person on the Alberta Racquetball Association board that was a Christian at a time. I remember I've had conversations with Jerry Slamko about faith. He gets quite irate about the whole thing and just kind of walks off in a little fit of tantrum. And so now we're left with 4 years later, Barbara May is still on the board, and John Halko is now the president of the Alberta Racquetball Association. And they continue my ban for life, apparently. So there's, you know, there's nothing I can do about it, right? I mean, if the other members of the Alberta Racquetball Association don't want to stand up for what's right and let a person continue to be banned in racquetball for life, there's nothing you can do about it. Whatever's going on in their mind, there's nothing you can really do about it unless they're willing to take the responsibility. I'm not going to take legal action, because I think the longer this goes on, the worse John Halko looks and the worse Barbara May looks, because they're actually just expressing their hostility towards my faith, trying to make it look like I've done something bad, which is why they banned me. But what did I do that was wrong, right? And so through these email exchanges, what continues to go on, since I've been playing racquetball again, because I quit playing racquetball after that happened. And it was actually literally mostly because of the inflammation in my elbow. I had tennis elbow and I had golfer's elbow. But I also quit because I was kind of disgusted with the the Alberta Racquetball Association, obviously. But in those letters back then, when I found out that not only the tournament was being canceled and that they were convening to ban me or to make a decision whether or not to ban me, I realized my window of opportunity was short at that point. So what I decided to do was email all the racquetball players in the R2 sports program across Canada, letting everybody know across Canada that this abusive behavior was taking place, this unjust discrimination against a Christian. And so they may use that as the reason why they ban me, but it's kind of, you're putting the cart before the horse. The reason why, that's not the reason why they can be banning me, because that's, I use that to expose them, because they were preparing their inquisition and I wasn't invited. I had no say in the matter. Whatever they were planning, they were clearly trying to make me look bad just by banning me. And I never got a reason. What happened was, after the banning, I got a letter in the mail. Through the email, they printed out all the emails and then they had me sign for it when somebody came to my door. And I look at it and they said, because of these emails, so what's wrong with these emails? And they don't say. The only thing I can really think of is Cam Bork emailed dozens of people saying that I was a, quote, lunatic for my faith in Christ. And, you know, I'm not going to sit back and not respond to that. I'm going to respond. And so I know that Cam Bork cheated on his wife with a woman named Michelle Sheepers. And it's because I slept with her too, in sin. See, I admit my sin, and if I was married, I would tell my wife that, you know, I cheated on you, because that's the right thing to do. I'd man up on the matter. Cam doesn't. His wife still doesn't know that he's cheated on her. And I'm sure if he's cheated on her this one time that I knew about with a woman that I was dating briefly, I'm sure there's others, right? So anyway, whether or not what I did was right or wrong in responding that way to show what a lunatic really is and how unloving a person can be towards their wife by cheating on them and keeping it a secret, whether or not that's right or wrong, that's not a reason to ban somebody. Nor is it a reason to ban somebody for life if I emailed everybody across Canada about this abuse of Barbara May and John Halko. So these are just red herrings. You have to understand what's really going on. Barbara May is covering up for her lie. And there's always money involved, right? She's trying to protect her own financial well-being, right? She doesn't want to get fired from her job for her negligence. So she had to lie to protect her hide. And John Halko is backing her as well. And I'm not a mind reader. I don't know what's going through their minds. But I take a look at all this evidence and I say, why have you banned me? You haven't given a reason. What's the reason? Anyway, you know Christianity is on their minds, because when I came back to play racquetball in March 2012, the first thing that happens to me is Manny Gregorio comes up to me and he says, hey, you know my aunt or my mom or somebody is a Jehovah Witness. And then I said to him, well, you know, a Jehovah Witness is not a Christian, right? A Jehovah Witness does not believe Jesus is God, so they're worshiping a false Christ, and therefore they're going to go to hell. Just as the Bible says, there would be many false Christs. Next thing that happens is Barry Old comes up to me. Very proudly he says, you are not allowed to enter into my racquetball league. As if I would even want to, right? Because no higher-ranked player is even playing in his league. But what was really telling is when he came up to me, he says, you are not allowed to talk about Christianity at racquetball. It's on their minds. It's affecting them. I think next thing that happened was, I went into the hot tub. I was talking to Al Bowman. But Al Bowman was very receptive, actually. We had a really good conversation about faith, and he took it under consideration, and I really enjoyed having that conversation with him and his opening his heart up to what Christianity is exactly. and who Jesus is. But then what next thing I remember that happened was Jack McBride, the president of the of Racquetball Canada, said, "Oh, 3 years ago, you accused me of not being a Christian," to which I replied, "Well, I really don't remember that conversation, but if that's true, I must have had a good reason. So do you believe Jesus is God?" And then he responded like this. He said, "I don't want to talk about religion." Isn't that funny? No Christian would ever respond that way. They say, "Praise the Lord, you're my brother in Christ." Because, you know, I believe Jesus is God too, and I was born again in such and such date, right? I was born again January 2001. Man, I could say so much. Anyway, let's compare, you know, all the bannings in the history of the Alberta Racquetball Association. There was an incident where somebody got 56 stitches. The person was banned for a year. And perhaps that's fair, I don't know. But what was unfair is they charged to that person over $500 for breaking the glass as a result of the fight. And that was unfair because the burden of that expense should fall on both parties. There was another incident that I'm aware of where Wayne Davidson physically attacked somebody. Actually, it was me. And totally uncalled for. And I remember Wayne Davidson was literally, he kicked me in the back, shoved me down, threw me to the ground. I wasn't even looking, you know, totally blindsided me. And there I am lying on my back. He jumps on top of me with his fist ready to slam into my face. And you think I, and he says, "Come on, hit me, hit me." And I say to him, "What are you, crazy? You weigh twice as much as I do. You're sitting on top of me and you want me to hit me so you can slam me in the face with your fist? Come on." And it was, you know, a totally embarrassing situation from him. But what was even worse in that situation is I heard from various people that he said that I was calling his house. I don't know what he was saying exactly, but they said something about, you know, threatening him and whatnot. Why in the world would I call Wayne Davidson after he physically attacked me? People are suggesting I should take legal action. I wasn't going to take legal action. I turned the cheek for the most part. Because I'm a Christian. And in fact, him, Wayne and I actually got along, you know, pretty well some time after that. Even though one time he smashed in a fit of rage, he smashed in the side of my car with his fist. But anyway, what the point of that whole story is that Wayne Davidson lied to protect his hide. He made up this story. And I like how this sort of relates to how Barbara May lied to protect her hide. People are lying to protect her hide. Cam Bork, through those emails when he responded, lied to protect his hide. He said, no, I never cheated on my wife. I would never do that. But we all know we got Michelle Sheepers would give testimony. And she's told me and he's told me that he's had sex with her and stuff. And he even said that sex with her was not very good. And I concur. That's rude to say, I know, but I'm just using them as points of evidence. So that's, you know, mentioned Wayne Davidson. We also mentioned, let's mention Bob Bear here. Bob Bear smashed in the glass door and smashed and fell apart completely. He didn't have to pay for any of that, apparently. Totally inconsistent with John Halko's other, these are John Halko's calls, by the way. John Halko used to, you know, required this other person to pay. I promise not to say who this other person's name is to him, and I promise I won't use his name. But John Halko charged him over $500 to pay for the full expense of the broken glass door, whereas in Bob Bear's case, he didn't have to. And Jack McBride, who's so unethical as the president of Racquetball Canada, he got Bob Bear to enter into the Vernon Racquetball Tournament a few days before the tournament started, even though several people who had registered months before the tournament were not allowed to enter into the tournament. So this is Al Cutress of Invernon, who runs the tournament, has this double standard. You know, he says he's very serious. I have to make sure that I, you know, don't upset anybody, make sure everybody gets registered in turn properly. But then he goes and does this. He gives some people the privilege of jumping in front of other people. So, and then Jack McBride, remember, is the person who got Bob Bear, who convinced Al Cutress to get Bob Bear into the tournament, even though Bob Bear had really no right to enter that tournament because there's still several people in front of him. And I really do want to keep talking about this because I've got so many articles that I've written on this, and I think it's really fascinating how people are being unethical, and I like how that I'm banned for life, actually. But there's another concern that I have is that Jack McBride's written a letter to me, and I believe he is going to be he's looking for a way to ban me from Racquetball Canada. And you know what? I'm perfectly fine with that. Because it just makes them look badder, and I'm being blessed by it as a result. Luke 6:22 says, "Blessed are ye when men shall hate you, and when they shall separate you from their company, and cast out, and shall reproach you, and cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake." So I'm just going to be receiving reward upon reward from all these actions that are being taken against me. Let's see, this video is getting pretty long, actually, 20 minutes. So what I'm going to do, instead of talking more about it, I'm just going to put the link at the bottom of the video, and you guys can go look at those articles whenever you want. Enjoy the reading. It's fun. I've enjoyed writing these articles because it's giving you the true story of what's really going on behind the scenes. When you confront them, like Barbara May and John Halko, about why did you ban me, you won't get a specific reason. It'll be vague. They'll say, hey, those emails, what about those emails? They don't say. They keep it very, very vague. Even Gerald Frederick, who used to be a president of the ARA or ERA, said to me that this is definitely religious prejudice that they're taking against me. Oh, I almost forgot. The funnest part of the story is I was playing racquetball for a few months in 2012. Started playing racquetball March 15th. And then around July, I get a letter from the manager of the Mayfield Racquetball Club, saying that, you know, I'm sort of banned from the club. It would be best that I not play there. It wasn't like a technical banning or anything, but she says, it's best that you probably not play there, because you're upsetting some people. I don't know who I was upsetting. I remember Mark, the UFC fighter, physically threatened me because I asked him, hey, I heard you were a Christian. He said, yeah. I said, well, so when were you born again? He says, well, you don't need to be born again. No, I was born again when I was born. I was born once. You don't need to be born again. But we all know John chapter 3, when Jesus is talking to Nicodemus, you need to get born again. John chapter 3, verse 3 and 7. So if you're not born again, you're not a Christian, right? But as I was walking and leaving him, because I knew I was talking to someone quite obstinate, he actually physically threatened me. And then 2 days later, I'd get the banning. So maybe that was part of it. At any rate, the manager, when I asked her, why did you ban me? She said it was because of the Alberta Racquetball Association. So somehow Barbara May and John Halko influenced her to ban me from sanctioned racquetball tournaments in Alberta. Okay, but the point of this whole story is, within a month later, word was given that the Mayfield Athletic Club was being closed down. Interesting, huh? So the racquetball players, just a couple of them, were talking about Manny Gregorio, Barry Old, I guess Cam Bork, Jerry Vasilich he's a really obnoxious person. He calls me a shithead and an asshole, and you know, he's not a very nice person. But anyway, these are the only four people I can think of, other than the board members of the Alberta Racquetball Association. Oh, and Al Cutress. Not Al Cutress. What's this guy's name? Gordon Cutting. You know, I entered the 2012 Edmonton Open, and then he removed me from the tournament. I asked him, why did you do that? He said, because of whatever you did 4 years ago. Well, what did I do 4 years ago? He doesn't say. Nobody knows what I did 4 years ago. So, of course, I've documented everything, and I put it all on the internet for everybody to see, to let you read, and hey, and get you to question what's going on. Right, is Barbara May and John Halko of sound mind and body? Are the other members of the Alberta Racquetball Association doing the right thing by being silent about this and letting a person continue to be banned year after year after year? I'm the number three ranked player in Alberta in racquetball right now. I'm trying to improve my ranking. I'm 37th in Canada. I'm the number one player in Alberta, 25 and older, and I'm the third ranked player in Canada, 45 and older. My goal is to be the number one ranked player in Canada, 45 and older, which is just 5 ranking spots, and hopefully to even do better than that. So I'm planning on playing in 7 tournaments every year, 4 in Saskatchewan, the 2 selection, and the nationals. And I don't even have to play racquetball in Alberta. It doesn't even serve any purpose to me because, you know, I've got Mitch Braley, who's one spot ahead of me in Canada, and Kobe Owasa, who's going to be, you know, the number one player in the world one day. And I don't think I can beat him. And besides, there's a tournament that I'm going to right now, which is in Regina, and he's going to that one, which is being held at the same time as the one in Calgary, the Calgary Open. And I'm going to the one in Regina, so I'm getting to play better players and hopefully move up in the ranking. And the reason why I moved up the ranking already is because I beat the ninth-ranked player in Canada, who was, what's his name, Ashton Duda, who's the second-ranked player in Canada, 18 and under. So that was a good accomplishment for me. Oh, the whole point of my story was that the Mayfield, we got word the Mayfield was being closed down a month after. So it was, you know, the Mayan calendars, they say something was going to happen on December 21st, 2012. Well, nothing happened, right? But the Mayfield was closed down in Edmonton. And a very nice club was closed down permanently. They're going to turn it into hotels. And I didn't even realize this. It was amazing. I didn't even realize this. Daryl Thomas called me one day and said that this was happening. And he said he suggested the reason is God. It's God's judgment on John Halko and Barbara May. Even those who are following in their footsteps, Manny Gregorio, Barry Old, these old people who play racquetball, they who are being hostile towards me, who they are not Christians, who are attacking a Christian, you know, requiring I apologize for something when I ask them, what am I to apologize for? And Manny doesn't know. Manny has confronted me several times to apologize. And I ask, well, what do I apologize for? And he doesn't know. You see how obstinate and belligerent some people can be? I have no problem apologizing. So I'm in complete agreement that this truly is 100% a judgment on these particular, we're not talking about a lot of racquetball players, we're just talking about these particular racquetball players in Edmonton who are now being disbanded. The Tower of Babel has come down. They're going to have to go to these courts or those courts somewhere. I've heard that they are being banned from, sorry, I shouldn't say banned, but the league, Barry's League, is being rejected by the Glen Allen Recreation Complex that has 3 courts, as well as the University of Alberta, which has 3 courts. So they're going to have to go to, you know, the rundown facility of the Kinsmen Club, which has only 2 courts. I think it doesn't have any viewing or glass courts or anything like that. So they're stuck there. And what's even more amazing is that the nicest facility now in northern Alberta is less than a mile from where I live. I live in Sherwood Park, Glen Allen Recreation Complex, a very nice facility, has 3 courts. They just got word of renovations, that they're getting funding for renovations, so they're going to be able to open up that 4th racquetball court, which is just temporarily being used as a weight room. So, I mean, I've received pretty good blessing here from all of this. And, of course, I don't even need to play those old people that are being hostile towards me. Why do I need to play people in their 50s, 60s, and 70s anyway? I've got enough other players in Edmonton to play. So that would be a judgment upon them. And I like, this is what's really interesting, is I beat Ashton Duda, right? But it was a tournament. It was the Saskatchewan Open, which was being held at the same time as the Edmonton Open, the last tournament at the Mayfield that I was going to play in, but Gordon Cutting, who's running the tournament, you know, kicked me out of the tournament. So I went to Regina to play, to beat Ashton, the ninth ranked player in Canada. That wouldn't have happened if Gordon Cutting didn't ban me from the Edmonton Open. What a blessing. Isn't that an amazing blessing? So God's working, Gordon Cutting's evil, Barbara May's evil, and John Halko's evil for good, at least for my benefit, to bless a Christian. Okay, it's 30 minutes. I've talked way too long already. I apologize. I hope you've watched the whole video, but if you do want to read more, there's a lot more in the articles that I've written on the subject, in other quotes from other individuals on the matter. I've talked to a lot of people, even Bob Smith, who hasn't played racquetball in decades. He says the ARA really needs to grow up, he says. Oh, and another person, what's his name? Doug Jones, who runs the junior league in Sherwood Park, has lots of kids. But none of them can get into the top 100. So there's a problem there. There's a problem that he's not able to get those kids into the top 100 in Canada. When I was 17, I played two tournaments and I was already ranked 35th in Canada. So there's a problem. He's got to get those kids in the top 100, not just juniors and sending them to the junior nationals, giving them free trips and free hotel rooms and all that sort of thing. I've talked to him about that, and there's something that he's not doing that he needs to do, and so hopefully that'll be improved. But Doug Jones is a pretty nice guy. He said that these atheists, that, you know, Manny Gagario, John Halko, Barbara May, Barry Old, he says these atheists, they're not as, these are new atheists, they're not as passive as they would like you to believe. They're actually quite aggressive in their hostility towards us Christians. Another person that was hostile to me was a girl by the name of Lori. I think she's on the board of the Edmonton Racquetball Association, Gloria or something like that. She was actually literally threatening me to try to get me banned from the Glen Allen Recreation Complex as well. Isn't that amazing? Brutal, brutal people. And so I can name other names, but that should be enough for now. Just please read the articles, enjoy yourself. It's all good. You want to ban me for life, that's perfectly fine. I see God's blessing and God's providence in all of this. But I would like the banning to go away because I think it's really getting absurd. And you guys are making yourselves look even more ridiculous in the process. So that's it. And I have nothing else to say for the moment. Okay, bye.